Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
At this time, our meeting will come to order, and I'll ask Mr. Sutton if he'll give the invitation, please.
Yes, if we can have a moment here before I have a small prayer, I would like to say this. This past Saturday, I stopped at a church in northern Guilford County. I do it quite often when I'm in that part of the county. It's a little church up near northern Guilford High School that they sell hot dogs every Saturday. And I had this parent and her daughter meet me at this church, and we all had hot dogs before we went to do our student driving. But I picked up this bulletin as we left, and it was the sermon for this coming Sunday. This past Sunday is obviously in regards to Thanksgiving, and it said, the quote was from Matthew 25:35, "I was hungry and you gave me food to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me a drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me." And the sermon for this past Sunday was titled, Thanksgiving is More Than a Feeling. And if we could have a moment, please. Our Heavenly Father, thank you for another beautiful fall day. Be with us tonight as we have our discussions in regards to county business. Be with the Burgess family, Tim Burgess and his family, as they attend personal family members in Alabama, family matters in Alabama. Be with them as they go and come back. Be with our military worldwide as they protect us from those who wish to do us harm. Please be with our fiscal world leaders to do the things that we need to do to save this world economy, not only in the United States, but worldwide. Please be with our leaders to do the tough things that need to be done and help us to do the same here locally. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, next is our public comment. Ms. Baum?
Am I the only one on that?
Yes, ma'am.
About 15 minutes.
I'm afraid you're
well,
afraid you
I'm going back and sit down then.
3 minutes.
3 minutes. Okay. Good evening, commissioners. I found the resolution amending uniform standards and claims against employees, officers, and officials on the consent agenda very interesting. It really begs more questions than it answers. Where is a copy of the resolution that this document is amending? Without knowledge as to what is in the resolution, it is impossible to say if the document is intended to be amended, a good thing or a bad one. Are commissioners even aware that this resolution exists? To what extent are these resolutions adhered to, and do commissioners know about them, follow them, or even agree with its contents? I did some research, and I think Mr. Kitchen was the attorney at the time. The resolution vests too much power to staff, especially the risk manager and the county attorney, providing them the latitude to settle cases without checks or balances from the commissioners and the public. In fact, the resolution establishes the framework for county staff to cover the mistakes of county staff. So I like the fox watching the hen house. Who is the risk manager for the county? I cannot find anything about this individual in the county website. Do they work for the county? Is it someone who reports to the commissioners? It is noted that the risk manager, with approval of the county attorney, has authority to settle claims. How extensive is that authority? Can the risk manager decide without input from commissioners or the public how to settle cases and remand that information from public scrutiny? Can the risk manager settle the issues with our sheriff without consult? To whom does the risk manager report? Is it the county attorney? In which case, we have a conflict with the risk manager asking approval of the county attorney, or is it the county manager, which can direct both the risk manager and the county attorney as to what to do? What if the risk manager is sued? Then what? How much latitude does the risk manager exercise? Can they settle claims of any amount? A basic question about resolutions: are these binding or just strong recommendations? What are the implications if the resolution is not followed? I do want to let you know or remind you that General Statute 132.1.3, settlements made by or on behalf of public agencies, public officials, or public employees, public records. It's a good one. This resolution begs, my computer froze, so I had to cut. This resolution begs questions. No.
I'm sorry.
Well, wish you a happy Thanksgiving.
Mr. Honeycutt, can you advise her who you need to talk with about this?
Clyde is the person who, and Rhonda Moracle right now is serving as our risk manager.
Okay. Does that help you?
Yeah, thank you.
So they can probably answer all your questions. We can. Okay. And I don't have any more public comments, so are there any commissioners' responses? All right, we'll go to the budget amendment, Mr. Bass.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Commissioners, this is kind of a continuation of a request I had earlier. You may remember a few months ago we had some additional money, $9,904 from the Division of Public Health Chronic Disease on our asthma prevention grant. So we got 4 months worth of funding then, so this is 8 months worth of the same grant. So this is what we're asking you all, if you'd be willing to help us continue on this most worthy project in terms of trying to reduce the incidence of asthma in our county.
Okay. I hear a motion.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Okay, nonprofit lease agreement. Mr. Burgess, and are you going to do that?
As Commissioner Sutton mentioned earlier, Tim is in Alabama. His father-in-law is gravely ill.
Oh,
so if you could just keep him and that family in your prayers, we'd appreciate it. But
okay.
With respect to the nonprofit lease agreement, in reviewing our facilities, we have not been able to find leases with the nonprofit agencies that occupy county facilities. We have ACTA, Friendship Adult Day Services, and Alamance County Community Services in our Elderly Services Building, which is on Martin Street, and also the Alamance County Dispute Settlement and Youth Services in the Court Services Building in Graham, which is right across the street. The lease that you have in front of you would set out the roles and responsibilities of the nonprofits, but also of the county. And with your approval, we would implement this as of January 1.
Any questions on this? Do y'all understand where all these places are?
I talked to Dennis Williams at ACTA, and he's reviewed it with his person and is ready to bring it to the ACTA board for approval. He didn't have any problems with it.
We did meet with all of the nonprofits last week and went over the lease to make sure that they had any questions or concerns, and we didn't hear back from them that there were any concerns.
Okay. I'll entertain a motion to accept this lease agreement.
Make a motion that we do.
All right.
Second.
Second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay. Okay, next is county manager reports.
Thank you, Madam Chairwoman. Just a quick update on the budget. We have placed a lot of budget information sheets within your agenda packet. Revenues and expenditures for the first quarter, through October 31st. Also, we've given you sales tax figures. Again, right now, over this time last year, sales tax is up 8.4%. We're at 38.33% of budget, and where we should be at about 42%. So we're in good shape with respect to sales tax. Over this time last year, total revenue is up over $2.6 million in our general fund, and expenditures are down over the same period about $1.7 million. So I really want to thank the department heads and also our outside agencies that we've worked with to make sure that our expenditures are staying as low as possible. We've not stopped. We're still looking at policies, procedures, environmental issues, electricity, heating policies, you name it. We're still trying to look at ways to do cost reduction for the county to ensure that we don't use fund balance. So There's a lot of information there. If you have any questions, just let me know.
Okay. Any questions on this? Is that all you have?
Couple more things.
Okay.
One of the things that you have in front of you tonight is a request for out-of-state travel. In front of you is an out-of-state travel request for our electronic 50B team to travel to Kentucky to work with a software company on finalizing the electronic 50B program that Alamance County is the pilot program for in the state. No local funding will be used for this travel, and sorry for it not being in your agenda packets, but the request came in today, and they needed to kind of get approval so they can begin making travel arrangements for that. And Cindy Brady is here. If you have any questions, Cindy with the Family Justice Center is heading up this program and for the Family Justice Center.
You might have any questions of Cindy?
What was the reason that we got selected? Maybe you can answer that. I think it's great that we did.
I am not sure how that came about.
Well, it's a result of, as you know, we the Family Justice Center, and we ask our legislators this year to, and where's Judge Robertson? Stand up here, buddy. Judge Robertson actually worked with our legislators to rewrite some legislation so that we could do this in Alamance County.
And so that's how we got chosen. And so the Governor's Crime Commission has a grant to do this statewide. And because we created the Family Justice Center, and the whole point of that is to provide domestic violence services under one roof, and this is a key component, and Alamance County is known for the way it collaborates and partners.
We're right. That's good. And thank you, Judge, for all your hard work down there.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Thank y'all. It was your commitment a few years ago
to
provide this facility that has ended up with folks like the Governor's Crime Commission seeking out Alamance County as folks who are on the cutting edge of taking care of the folks in our own county.
Yeah, something needed.
Judge Robertson, we're still the only place in the state that has the assault me.
We are.
And we're going to be,
and it's wonderful,
first or second in the nation to have the electronic.
Well, good.
50B.
The 50B, mm-hmm. Good. Good. It's very important.
Close to reality.
Yes, yes. It's very important.
What's your biggest success story to date over there as far as what this has yielded? If you could generically tell us one.
I can tell you one because it happened about a month after I was there, and I was sitting in my office, and one of the domestic violence officers came in, and she said, you know what, I have got this woman, and I don't think she's going to make it through the weekend. It was a boyfriend situation. Her boyfriend is trying to kill her. He's already beat her up. She said, I don't know if there's room in the shelter. I don't know what to do. And I said, well, you know what? The Family Abuse Services Director is right down the hall, so let's just trip down there and see if we can't work this out. And so that Friday afternoon at 3 o'clock, we had a plan for that woman so that she would survive the weekend, essentially. And her boyfriend eventually got put in jail. There were criminal charges. He beat her pretty badly. And so that really has helped having everything there to collaborate with each other. And the other thing is having the advisory team. There have been a couple of just systemic things that have come up that just getting everybody together and talking through it has actually eliminated some time for people.
Commissioner, every now and then I get to go to meetings on the state level, and I'm always impressed and I'm proud because Alamance County's often referred to as a leader in the area of domestic violence, and a lot of folks contributed to that happening, including the commitment here. So I brag on y'all a lot about your commitment, because these are tough times. These are times where we have to be very vigilant,
proactive,
but we also, there are those who need support in our community, and y'all stepped up to the plate. Actually, it's folks come to us now because of y'all's commitment. Appreciate that.
So we need a motion.
Need a motion for that.
I'll make a motion that we approve them to go on that.
To go on the trip. Okay, have a motion.
Second.
And a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
No opposed.
Yes, couple sir. Of things. Just sitting here thinking, if the board likes, maybe we can work with Cindy and Susan to do a update on exactly what the Family Justice Center has done at our next meeting. So we'll have a presentation of the partners and kind of give you where we're at over a year later, year and a half almost later. So. Couple just a quick announcements about dates. On December 1st at 9 a.m., we will have our Employee Service Awards breakfast, and that will be here in the Commissioner's Room. And that will be for honoring our employees that have over 20 years of service to Alamance County. So would love for you to come for that. Also, remember our joint breakfast meeting with ABSS is on December 13th. And then we have the Community Leaders Breakfast at Alamance Community College on December 7th. And that is all I have, Madam Chairwoman.
Okay. All right. Next, are there anything on the consent agenda that you want to pull off? Anybody?
I'm good with everything.
Any questions about anything on it? If not, I'll entertain a motion to accept the consent agenda.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. No opposed. Okay. I move that we now go into closed session pursuant to North Carolina General Statute Section 143-318.11A3 in order to preserve the attorney-client privilege between the county attorney and the Board of Commissioners to discuss and consider a claim against the Alamance Caswell LME in its dealings with Piedmont Behavioral Health and to consult with the county attorney in order to preserve the attorney-client privilege between the county attorney and the Board of Commissioners regarding the case of United States versus Alamance County et al. And all of it. I need a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Okay, Tom made the motion and Eddie was second. Okay, at this time we are going into closed session and we shall return. President.